The new Nissan Navara comes with many best-in-class technologies, including an array of Nissan intelligent mobility features and safety systems, making it the most advanced Navara yet. It is the toughest ever built by Nissan, created to meet and beat the toughest road conditions in the world. Powering the Navara is a 2.5-liter turbo diesel engine that has proven reliable in sub-Saharan Africa driving environments. In terms of safety, the new model creates a 360-degree safety shield for the vehicle, protecting the driver and passengers from potential risks. In order to boost local production for these vehicles following its launch in Ghana, Japan Motors has disclosed of plans to commission its assembly plant in Ghana next year. The managing director of Japan Motors, Salem Kalmoni, announced this during the unveiling ceremony at the La Palme Royal Beach Hotel.
You'll be happy to know that the Nissan Navara you see today will soon be assembled in Ghana. We're busy in the final phase of construction, tooling, and training of our personnel. We hope to commission our assembly plant at Tema on schedule in the first quarter of this year. I know this is good news for all buyers, especially government bodies, as our government has mandated you procure Ghana-assembled vehicles. Government has graciously waived off duty and VAT on locally assembled vehicles. This will make the Navara cheaper than those imported pickups of any brand.
General Manager and West African Rep for Nissan, Imad Gorayeb, outlined the company's plans of boosting production of their vehicles in Africa.
We are also investing heavily in Africa as part of Nissan Next because we can see the potential of this market, and especially here in Ghana, where our partners, long-time partners, Nissan, Japan Motors, are busy finishing what we will be the most modern automotive assembly plant in West Africa for the Nissan brand. We are now producing the entire family of vehicles in Africa, in South Africa, from the entry-level single cab version to the luxury double cab Pro 4X, all of which will be available here in Ghana from today onwards.
The guest of Anna, CEO of Jospon Group, Joseph Siao Ijapon, stressed on the need for Ghanaians to support local companies and products in order to help them grow.
I humbly want to dwell for us to patronize local entrepreneurs, our products. This country belongs to us. And the patronization of an investment by a local entrepreneur is very essential. We all were here. When we started Made in Ghana Goods, one of the uniform and the material that printers were producing, we named it Ajwa Yankee, and the next day it died off. So anything that local is being done or manufactured here, the patronization becomes very, very low, and the support then becomes very difficult.